All right, Shalom, Akim, Shalom. First and foremost, as always, I want to start off this lesson by giving all praise, honor, and infinite glory to Yahweh, Bahashim, Yahweh Shai, Bahashim, Rakakudash, double honors, unto the apostles and the elders of Great Millstone, the Tartus Truth, and the Duru Well. Much peace, love, blessings, and many salutations unto you brothers out there laboring in this word, in all truth and in all sincerity, giving your bodies as a living sacrifice, which is all reasonable service. To you sincere believers out there in general, both men, women, and children, unto you I say Shalom as well. Okay, and Lord, one of this lesson will be edifying. I'm the brother Shapal, out of the Great Millstone Dallas branch, coming to you all again with another lesson through the spirit and power of Yahweh Shem Yahshai. All right, within this lesson, you know, it's going to be something of a quick hit. But within this lesson, I'm going to entitle it, "It's Through Mercy Alone We Must Fear." Okay, because when you begin to understand the concept of that, everything has a lot, right? Everybody, every individual, you know, it has a particular purpose toward playing a role in the Heavenly Father's will. And when it's all said and done, what He commanded, what His thoughts were, what they, you know, what it is to be, essentially, will be accomplished. Okay. Now the elect that are written, right? You read about in Revelation 14 chapter, those that'll be found as virgins with no guile in their mouth before the Heavenly Father. Those in which He will justify, essentially. They will have a particular pattern of works, right? They will have, you know, casted away the world. They will have, you know, done these things in which the scripture says pretty much prescribed, you know, putting on as the election. That's exactly what they will be doing. And that's exactly what we're trying to do and striving to do in these days, okay? But in understanding, again, predestination, and understanding that the Heavenly Father has chosen particular vessels from the foundations of the earth, despite what they think they're doing at this particular time, well, it's all going to be made manifest who is and who isn't His, man. See, like the scripture says, and we'll actually start there. I have a few precepts lined up, but we'll start right here. Like I said, you know, this will be some of a quick hit, but it's just a reminder that man, we got to really fear Yahweh Shem Yahshai with everything that we do, man. Okay. Salakia, bear with me. Right, and this is a quick, short precept. Okay, Matthew 22 and 14. "For many are called, but few are chosen." All right, few are going to be of that number. It's already numbered, right? Every individual out here has either, you know, if they're of the nation of Israel, they have either a two-third number written for them, or they have a one-third number written for them. And then you have those amongst the one-third as well, you know, not just the believers, not just those that you know, support, but the prophets, okay, those returning spirits, in which, you know, will be written in the book of life. Those spirits, okay, I lost my train of thought, but they're back here today, okay. You're gonna have, again, particular people, particular men, women, and children who aren't gonna make it. And they may right now at this very moment be in the truth, consider themselves to be in the truth. It's not of him that willeth, like it says in Romans 9, not of him that willeth, nor of him that runneth, but of the Heavenly Father that showeth mercy. At the end of the day, it's according to the will of the Heavenly Father. Who's going to make it on the chariots, right? Those that have to give up the spirit on this side, who will be of that number and who won't? Like, yo, that's a reminder to fear the Lord, man. Fear Yahweh Shem Yahshai. Reverence the Heavenly Father. Love Him with all your being, man, and all your might, because the scripture says we can never go far enough, right? So let's see. Let's go to Romans, the 8th chapter, right? Just to back up what we're saying, okay? Romans 8 and 28, okay, it says, "And we know that all things work together for good to them that love the Most High, to them who are the called according to His purpose. For whom He did foreknow, He also did predestinate to be conformed to the image of His Son, that He might be the firstborn among many brethren." Right? It says, "Moreover, whom He did predestinate, them He also called, and whom He called, them He also justified." Now, we've seen men, you know, brothers that are particularly of age, You know, myself, I'm still a babe, but brothers that have, the elders, the apostles, you think about the apostles, they've seen men come and go. The elder apostle Rakad, you know, said, man, it's like a revolving doors, how he's seen men come and go in this truth. Okay, but they were called at one point in time. They served a particular purpose, right? They may have raised some brothers up. They may have, pretty much brought brothers up on a level through the Spirit of the Lord. But ultimately, when it was all said and done, where are they now? So see, it goes to show that particularly in the time of Jacob's trouble, there's going to be a lot of men out here that are going to fold, man. Those that you would have never thought would fold. A reminder to constantly fear Yahweh Hashem Yahweh Shai in everything that you do, man. To constantly put on as the election. To constantly gear your mind, okay, because the kingdom starts within you. Gear your mind, your mentality towards just completely relying on the Lord, man. Just understanding that you need Yahweh Hashem Yahweh Shai no matter what. Like nothing is of you, right? So putting on these patterns of works are good. Pray for the Lord. You got to, again, prayer. Yahweh Shai said that whatever ye shall ask of the Lord in my name, the Heavenly Father in my name, he shall give unto you. So praying that the Lord don't take the spirit from you. Praying that he keeps you in the spirit. You know, praying that he gives you the spirit to overcome in adversity and trials and tribulations, especially coming into the time we're coming into. Okay? Let's see. This is Isaiah. And I know we always say, you know, it'll be a quick hit, which this, you know, Lord willing, this actually is. I actually only have two precepts left after this one. Because I got to clock back in here in a second. But this Isaiah 33 and 6. Okay, and this is one we all know. It says, "And wisdom and knowledge shall be the stability of thy times, and strength of salvation. The fear of the Lord is his treasure." You see? That's the foundation. Faith and fear. Those are foundational principles in which we're geared to maneuver a certain way towards the Heavenly Father that is appeasing unto our power, man, unto our God. Okay? So that's what's going to keep us, that wisdom and knowledge which has been gifted unto us through the Spirit. Those are the things that are going to keep us stable in the times to come, because understanding, we know prophecy. All right? We've been gifted the understanding of the testimony of Yahweh Shai. Prophecy. And in that being opened unto us, like it talks about in Revelation, the 5th chapter, that Lamb, the Lamb that loosed the seals, Yahweh Shai, returning back to the heavens after he overcame death and loosed the seals. That way that we may have this same mind, all right, as Yahweh Shai did. Let's actually grab that. That we may overcome, okay? I want to say it's Philippians 2 and 5, okay? And we'll actually read down. We'll actually jump down after we read this. Okay, Philippians chapter 2, verse 5. It says, "Let this mind be in you, which was also in HaMashiach Yahweh Shai." You see? Verse 6. "When being in the form of the Most High, thought it not robbery to be equal with the Most High, but made himself of no reputation, and took upon him the form of servants." Because Yahweh Shai knew that he was the only begotten. He knew his rank. The head of all spirits. Come on, man. He knew his rightful position on the right-hand throne of the Heavenly Father. And he knows that he's going to rule in the kingdom to come. But he knew he had to come down here and make himself of a same stature, if you will, likened unto us. But it says that he was a little, what did it say, Hebrews? I want to say it says he was a little above the angels. All right. See the Hebrews 1 or 2. Thou hast made him Salakia. These are just coming to me. A little lower than the angels. Hebrews 2 and 7. Thou madest him a little lower than the angels. Thou crownest him with glory and honor, and didst set him over the works of thy hands. Right? Because in the beginning, the hands pretty much represented what? The Alahayim. under Yahweh Shai again, that are going to be basically those the same spirits from before the foundations of the earth was laid. Those are the same spirits that's going to be joint heirs with him, man. But he, again, going back to the point, he came down here and like I said, put him a little lower than the angels, you know, above all men, obviously, but he was in the flesh, just like us, man. He was in the flesh. All right, Philippians 2, getting to the point. All right, we're going to jump to the point. All right. Verse 12, Philippians 2 and 12 and 13, it says, wherefore, my beloved, as ye have always obeyed, not as in my presence only, but now much more in my absence, work out your own salvation with fear and trembling, man. We have to maneuver with that mindset 24/7, man. That's our only hope. That's our only hope. Because in that mindset, hey, Yahweh Shai said, in your patience, possessing your souls, in that mindset, will Lord willing be able to overcome and be a part of that number. Work out your own salvation with fear and trembling. If the man next to you can't work it out for you, I mean, you're praying to the Heavenly Father that these things come, and he's going to give you the Spirit, Lord willing, but you have to put the action in down here on the earth. But those actions are prompted through fear, man. Fearing Yahweh Hashem Yahweh Shai. We have to work out our own salvation, knowing the terror of the Lord, knowing these things are about to come, and judgment is about to take this place by storm, all right? That we got to work it out with all fear and all trembling, man. For it is the Most High, verse 13, for it is the Most High which worketh in you both to will and to do of his good pleasure. And the Heavenly Father controls both good and evil. He kills, he makes alive, there's no God but him, right? So you got particular men that are coming into this thing just to be condemned. Are we excluded from that? No, man. So we got to fear Yahweh Hashem Yahweh Shai with all our mind, man. The fear of the Lord is his treasure. Okay, the fear of the Lord is his treasure, man. I mean, there's so many more scriptures we could go into, but I'm gonna just leave it off there, man. Lord, when it was edifying, all right? Fear the Lord, man. Just I'm gonna say it one more time. The fear of Yahweh Hashem Yahweh Shai is the root to us obtaining, man. Shalom.